on the market you will find skim milk, full cream milk, semi-skim soy milk, light soy, you name it. The easiest milk to use is full cream milk, just because of the consistency of protein and fat. A good thing is to use nice fresh milk from the fridge, not too warm. That will give you an advantage to stretching your milk much more evenly and much easier. So what you want to do is you want to fill up your jug, not all the way to the top, because as I mentioned before, you want to stretch the milk, and if you fill it up all the way to the top and then you stretch the milk, which means the milk's going to overflow, it's going to fall out of the jug. A good way is any kind of jug you use has a spout. If you just fill up the fresh cold milk all the way to where the spout just is starting, and that's a very good indication. What you're doing when you stretch your milk, you want to irrigate the milk. You actually, through the steam wand, will push air into the milk, which then will produce tiny little bubbles, which then gives a certain amount of texture, which will give you a really beautiful coffee. You don't want to overheat the milk, which then means you've probably burned it and it's not going to taste very nice. So also you want to not heat it up not enough, because that's not going to be the right result as well. You should always have your hands on the jug, which then will make you feel the temperature rising. If you cannot handle the heat with your hands, imagine your lips or your tongue, for that matter, try to handle the heat. It will look like almost like paint. It's very silky, very thickish, and it will taste very sweet as well. You want to have the milk nozzle just touching the surface so that you don't immerge the steam wand too deep into the milk. Once I've done the texturing, I pretty much just have to wait till the milk has the right temperature, which my fingers will tell me very soon. Et voilà. Now if I end up with any bigger bubbles, which I don't want, I can just knock it down. Also what I want to do right now is I spin my jug a little bit around to also make sure it doesn't separate too quickly for me to use it in my coffee.